Have you ever wondered why Jane Fonda seems to be aging backwards and has an incredible vibrancy to her? I'm going to break down what I think she's doing regularly from a provider perspective, as I am an aesthetic nurse, and I have been so since 2011, to help you possibly undergo some of the treatments she's had also so that you too can age and possibly well. Now for the fun part, let's get into some of the photos that I found online where I can kind of go with you and describe my expert understanding as to what she's had done and what I might do differently. Okay, let's take a look at some of Jane Fonda's before and after photos. In this photo, there is a picture of her in her mid 20s, and then a picture of her in her late 70s, early 80s. Oh my gosh, she looks amazing, right? What her incredible god or goddess of a plastic surgeon has done for her is really maintain really nice cheek shape here. And she pretty much has almost like the same, you know, jawline or chin here, which is great. She has had a number of surgeries to reduce the waddle, as she likes to call it. So her, you know, the distance from here and here is, you know, shorter when she's younger, and then here is quite a bit higher. And in fact, the opposite tends to happen. The corners of the mouth tend to come down quite a bit more as you age, giving you that downward turn of the mouth, which actually makes you look older. I love this photo. I love how her surgeon and who's doing her injectables is just keeping her looking amazing. Let's take a look at this next photo, shall we? So her before and then after photo, I would say there might be about 10 to 15 years between these photos. It's just speculation. I don't actually know the dates they were taken. But as you can see in this photo here, this is probably a pre-facelift photo. Definitely she's got more fullness here and less fullness here. And then that's actually been kind of flipped around. As we age, we start out with an upside down triangle. So I'm gonna say that her face here, when she's actually older, is more in alignment with that. And then in the before photo here, where she is younger but looks older, she looks older because of this excess fullness in the lower part of her face. So by pulling this back, she might have even lost some weight too. She definitely looks younger in this photo here. All right, here is a 100% definitive sign that she's had either cheek implants or dermal fillers to her cheeks. Let's take a look at this beautiful before and after photo of Jane Fonda. This picture here is her, you know, younger, and then here she's older. And what I want to highlight are these lines. This is what we're really looking at in this picture here. These horizontal lines in the under eyelid area are what I consider to be telltale facelift lines. So when you see someone and they have all these lines going in this direction, it's because the skin's been yoinked back, right? That's what a facelift does. It pulls the skin back. So when people have very thin skin, you'll see these, you know, horizontal pull lines quite a bit more easily. And in this picture here, you can see that they're reduced, and they, I think, look less here because she's also had a cheek filler here, which looks great. So you see how it's kind of like flat here, and then here she's got beautiful rounded contours. So she's either had cheek implants, which I think she's had, and or dermal fillers. And if you look at her skin here, you can see how she has so much extra skin on her upper eyelids. She's definitely had an upper blepharoplasty, which removes this excess skin here, and it looks absolutely fantastic. You can see, you know, more whites of her eyes here. Here, you know, her eyes are just like totally black. It's just makeup you're seeing. You're not actually seeing her bright eyes. You know, hands down, she looks better, right? She looks fantastic. I wouldn't be surprised if she's also getting some neuromodulators around her eyes to open things up a little bit and give a non-surgical eyelid lift. But in this photo, she's 100% had both surgical and non-surgical eyelid interventions. She looks fantastic. Yet another before and after photo that I love of Jane Fonda. I spoke too soon because I found one that I'm not too keen on, actually. So this was 2016 and then 2017. And what I don't like about this is that she kind of has like a little bit of a frozen look, I'd say. Her eyes actually look a little bit smaller after as opposed to before. And she's just like a little too smooth in here and a little too puffy in here. This is not the type of volume that you would see in a woman in their late 70s, early 80s, right? This is volume, that's cheek volume you'd see in someone in their 20s. So it's sometimes a bit of a trade-off when you are 60 plus and you have these fine lines or wrinkles pop up, especially to the upper lip here. What you don't want to do is just like fill them until the cows come home. It's important to become okay with some of the fine lines and wrinkles that are normal to experience with age. So when you look at Jane Fonda, what I don't like about this photo is that she's just too smooth. So it's kind of gives a bit of a fake look. Also, one thing I want to mention is her eyebrows. So you see this little gap here. You know, her brows should be brought in a little bit more, either with microblading or makeup. The microblading is a whole other story that we'll talk about shortly here. But yeah, I like people to look natural. You know, she's still got some lines here that looks great. These are definitely reduced, but those are telltale facelift lines. I don't think she could ever get rid of those. Those are just a couple lines to embrace. And her neck, oh my gosh, look at her neck. It looks so good. It looks the same. You know, she's getting some laser treatments there. She's getting some dermal fillers there. All sorts of great things. But she's absolutely getting everything. Regular skin and laser treatments, neuromodulators like Botox, Xeomin, and Dysport, dermal fillers like hyaluronic acid, Juvederm, Restylane, things like that. Probably cheek implants, probably a chin implant also. And she looks fantastic. Go Jane Fonda. Don't be too hard on yourself on your journey of aging well. Obviously Jane Fonda has, you know, a limitless supply of money to spend on procedures, things like that. All you can really hope for is to, you know, maximize your lifestyle, maximize what you're doing daily with your skincare routine, getting medical rejuvenation treatments like chemical peels, hydrofacials, IPL, skin resurfacing treatments, getting the odd eyelid lift or, you know, even a facelift if you need to. But the trick is to prevent the need for surgeries. However, some people, you know, that's really the best option for them. So when someone comes to me who's 60 plus and they've never taken care of their skin, sometimes they're a facelift candidate. The trick is to avoid the need for a facelift so that you can look more natural as you age. My generation is all about the generation of prevention. Her generation was the generation of, you know, frying yourself outside with your baby oil and your iodine and the reflector shields and all of that. I personally can only hope to look as incredible as she does in her 80s. And I do have some pretty inspirational clients in their 80s and 90s who are really motivating me to put all this awesome information out there to share with you guys that it's not just about getting plastic surgery, but it's really about doing the inner stuff as well. You can't outsmart a bad lifestyle or bad beauty routine. You know, you gotta do the work, right? Her plastic surgeon and the whole team is just doing a bang up job looking after her and holding her hand and getting her to do what's appropriate at just the right times. There was one point where, you know, I think she was just a bit swollen from her cheek implants or dermal fillers or something, but she's looking great now. She easily looks 25 plus years younger than she actually is. So hats off to her team. There you have it. It's not a quick fix. Let me know what questions you have about, you know, maybe different celebrities or something you're considering having. Head on over to rachelvarga.ca where you can connect with me further there. And I have a number of other free resources for you to kind of absorb to help you along your journey towards aging well for many years to come. So here's to all of us aging impossibly well, like Jane Fonda. We got the technology to do so, so it's kind of within our reach. All right, have a good one. Bye, guys.